Deputy Brendan Howland, please.
Jan Corla. Taoiseach, last Thursday, the Minister for Housing urged Dáil Éireann to reject my party's social and affordable housing bill. He said that our bill preempted delivery of a commitment in his action plan for housing and homelessness to publish a strategy for the rental sector. We find ourselves, quite frankly, in a daft position now. Today you announced your strategy for the rental sector, and in 2 days' time, the House will be invited to vote down a housing bill on the basis that it was premature until that strategy was published. And I hope all members of the House remember on Thursday that that was the reason given for not providing rent certainty. Minister Coveney promised that the rental strategy would, above all else, provide predictability for tenants and for landlords and would improve security of tenure. So we cleared the decks and waited expectantly. And today, bluntly, your government failed that test. I think the only reason your government could stand over this excuse for a strategy is that you have no real grasp of the nature and scale of the problem. Tenants are facing increasing pressures, increasingly unaffordable rents, insecurity of tenure, and poor standards. Many single people and families now spend 40% of their net income on modest private rental accommodation. And as we've just heard, in the last year, rents have gone up an unprecedented 12%. Increasing supply obviously is a solution, but that alone is unlikely to stabilise or reduce either house prices or rents. Everyone, or at least everyone apart from the government and the Fianna Fáil party, is now agreed that we need rent control. Threshold, Focus Ireland, Simon, the McVerry Trust and the NESC are all of that view. And the All-Party Committee on Housing and Homelessness recommended that rent reviews be linked to the CPI or a similar index. There is virtual unanimity on doing this. But even that isn't enough to persuade, for some reason, this minority government and Fianna Fáil. You know that the rent regulation is the norm in Germany, in France, in Belgium, in the Netherlands, in Denmark and in Sweden. You know that Labour didn't become converts to rent regulation in opposition. We did our best to get movement on it when we were sitting on your side of the House. But you also know how ferocious the lobby on these issues was and remains, how a concerted campaign waged by Irish and international property and mortgage interests against any form of rent regulation has so far held sway. The biggest landlord in the country, when interviewed in the Irish Times last month, commented that what a great market the Irish rental market was.
Thank you, Deputy.
But even he said he was content with 3% increases. Now, astonishingly, the government and Fianna Fáil believe that a 4% limit is acceptable. It's not enough. So I ask you, Taoiseach, even at this late hour, to accept the consensus that rent controls in the crisis market that we have now are required and accede to allowing the bill that is before the dollar will be voted on Thursday to be agreed.
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
First of all, Deputy Howland, you're perfectly entitled to put forward your bill. I would say that the Labour bill was focused on keeping rent to the consumer price index nationally. And this would undermine completely the ability to supply the necessary number of houses to help ease this situation. There were other elements in your bill which are very compatible with what the Minister has produced today on behalf of government, that is longer tenancies for tenants through a variety of arrangements with landlords. I point out to you that new dwellings are exempt under this programme, as are completely refurbished existing dwellings, which brings them into the scope and scale of what the Minister is talking about here. This is targeted and focused. Your bill seems to be a national clampdown. And remember, Deputy Howland, that landlords in the vast majority of cases are private owners of private property, and clearly there's an issue in respect of determining what rent increase might apply. So what the Minister is doing here is, under an assessed and agreed system where pressure exists for rent inflation over a period, to set a cap on the rent that can be the rent increase that can be levied, and within that, that the rent pressure, the rent pressure zone, would apply for a 3-year term. There may be additions to that, or there may be areas that may drop out of it. But this is based on balancing the opportunities for tenants to have predictability and certainty, to have much longer tenancies be available to them, but also in respect of incentives for landlords to continue to supply accommodation which can be rented. And I'd point out to you that there has been a significant increase in the number of tenancies over the years. So there have been a situation where people are happy to enter into tenancies that are compatible with their needs, and that can only be effective where you deal with the supply of houses, and that's the other focus of the programme being brought in by the Minister for Housing. Clearly, that's been a fundamental issue that has been lacking in the country since the collapse of the construction sector a number of years ago. And this is part of the overall housing strategy approved now by government and hopefully accepted by members of the House here, in the context of giving predictability and opportunity, and at the same time a balance between the availability of existing tenancies. The new houses are exempt and completely refurbished. Existing dwellings are exempt. This is a time-limited focus strategy in order to allow the opportunity for supply to come on stream.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Howland.
You're arguing an increasingly lonely and isolated, unsustainable position. Do you not accept the views of those who are at the front line, Threshold, Focus Ireland, Simon, the McVerry Trust, even the NESC, in relation to these matters? Are they all wrong, and only yourselves and Fianna Fáil are right on this issue? You see, you're proposing a rent increase, an allowable rent increase, a multiple of any other index, 8 times consumer price index. How could that be justified? Someone paying €1,500 a month can, under your plan, see an additional €19,000 of after-tax income go on rent over the next 3 years. I mean, that's an extraordinary amount of money that could be devoted to alleviating household pressures. It's just not acceptable. So I would ask you, Taoiseach, I mean, the notion that the only pressure zones are Dublin and Cork, you're famous for talking to people over the garden wall and on your travels around the country. You know that these rental pressures exist in Louth and Meath and Kildare and Wicklow and Wexford and probably Mayo. They can be designated. They're not in your plan.
But Deputy, time is up.
The Minister for Housing is arguing a plan that he's published 40 minutes ago. He might at least have given us the chance to debate it. Well, I've read your leaks this morning. We'd like the doll to be treated with some respect, that we might see it before you send people out to present it in the media.
Deputy.
But the bottom line, Taoiseach, is simply this. We have a real crisis here in terms of sustaining people in their houses. Would you accept that the bill before us on Thursday is one that merits at least being passed the second stage so that we can debate it in committee?
Thank you. Taoiseach, a minute to conclude.
No, because it recommended the consumer price index. Obviously, these are private properties, and perhaps if you had taken the time to look at the designation process, the housing agency, in consultation with the relevant local authority, proposes that an area be designated. Thank you, Deputy Burton, as an RPZ. The Minister requires that the RTB would prepare a report indicating, based on the recent price data which the RTB collects and uses to compile the quarterly RTB rent index, whether the criteria for designation is valid or not. And the criteria for that designation are whether in the area concerned annual rent inflation has reached or exceeded 7% in four of the last six quarters, and that the average rent in the most recent quarter is above the national average rent. And if the RTB confirms to the Minister that these two criteria have been met, the Minister will then make the order, and that order applies for 3 years. So it is a focused, targeted strategy to deal with the question of predictability and certainty for tenancies, but also to give the opportunity for accommodation to continue to be rented. New houses are exempt, new buildings are exempt, as are fully refurbished existing tenancies. And areas can come into the RPZ or can drop out of it, depending on the assessment in terms of the rent inflation over that period.